Here is what I gather from the code. We are importing AV Foundation at the very top. This tells me that we will use a library from this framework. And sure enough, we use AV Audio Recorder, which sounds like a library that will help us record audio. If we look at how this object Audio Recorder is being initialized a little bit further down the code, we will notice that while creating its instance, we are giving it something called a file path. Now, this seems like the path or the address of a file on our phone where we actually want to record our audio. And it seems that this last line will actually record the audio. So far, so good. Let's investigate this thing called file path a little bit more. Now, all of this code here, it seems to me, is helping us get to the file path or the location of our recorded audio. It looks like this line of code here is getting the path of a directory within our app. Now, the thing to notice here is that our app can't just store a file anywhere on the phone. That would actually create serious security implications. So what we are doing is getting the path to the document directory within our app. This is a place where our app is actually permitted to store files. Then we are getting the current date and time from the phone and converting it into this format. And it seems to me that we are using that as the name of our audio file. I think what this mechanism does is that it ensures that no two audio files are of the same name in our documents directory folder. All right, now that we have a high-level understanding of this code, let's add this to our project and see if it works. By the way, all of this code is available in the instructor notes for you to experiment with.